Their opt-out deadline is likely going to be Thursday or Friday. I think that's perfectly fine because you got to know who is going to be on your team once you get into camp. You know, we're in camp. We are ready to rock and roll. I think it's perfectly fine to ask these players to decide whether or not they're going to be playing this season by this weekend. Do you agree?
I'm okay with that. There is a part of me that thinks once you get into camp, if you see things you're not a fan of, you still should have the ability to walk away without punishment.
Well, I mean, that would be an entire week, right? Because at camp's open July 28th. So, well, more than a week. Actually, July 28th was, what, Tuesday of last week? So, I think, you know, a week and a half, if you don't like what you're seeing in camp, you can opt out. I think that's perfectly fine. Don't you think that's enough time?
I guess. I don't know.
Yeah. Matt said, why is it that in football, basketball, and baseball in New York, you have one franchise in each sport that doesn't know what they're doing and the other is run well? Eh.
Yeah. You can't force an owner to do anything.
Yeah. I wish I had a good answer. I wish I had a good answer. So I think the deadline is fine. They're not going to be able to keep players on the team if they want to opt out, like, in the middle of the season. You just saw it with Cespedes, right? Like, he said he wanted to play. He goes out, he plays, and then 8 games in or 9 games in, whatever it is, he bounces. Like, you can't force a guy to play, but at least this gives teams an idea of who is going to be on the roster and who's not, right? And it's not right up to the last minute. Somebody doesn't decide, you know, the day before the first game, hey, you know what? I'm not comfortable. I'm out. So, I don't think it's that bad. All right, next, final topic, and this is going to hurt your overs, Chris. I hate to tell you. The Raiders have announced that their new stadium will be completely empty for the entire season. Did this surprise you at all?
A little bit, but, I mean, okay. No, it didn't surprise me. Sorry. When I heard about it today, I felt like this is this direction this thing's going. We're just not going to get fans in the stands.
Yeah, I don't think we will for college football. I don't think we will for the NFL at this point. I think they will. Some teams will try, but I think by the end of the season there will be none. That's just, you know, blind guessing. You know, throwing darts in the dark, you know, all that kind of stuff. But the statement was, there's nothing more important to the Raiders organization than the health and safety of our players, coaches, staff, stadium workers, and fans. After intensive consultation with healthcare officials and state and community leaders, we have made the difficult decision to play the Las Vegas Raiders 2020 inaugural season at Allegiant Stadium without fans in attendance. This decision is based on our commitment to protect the health of our fans and the entire community in response to the coronavirus pandemic affecting us all. This decision also ensures fairness to you, our PSL holders, given the challenges and potential inequities associated with determining who can and cannot attend specific games if the stadium were to operate at a reduced capacity. While the current situation is not how any of us envision celebrating the opening of the stadium, when circumstances permit, we look forward to sharing an unparalleled game day experience in the magnificent stadium you helped build. I'm going to guess you don't have the over anymore. The Brown Yeti just added. He said, I was wondering if Chris still had the over. Like, not at this point. Not at this point. That's a lost bet. That's a lost bet. It sucks. It definitely sucks. But on the positive side, I mean, we are trending more towards football than it looked like a few weeks ago. So with that said, you know, I'm feeling okay about at least getting some football this season. So yep. Now what that's going to look like and how many weeks and how many games and all that kind of stuff, who knows? It is all a crapshoot at this point, but we're here for it, and we're going to be covering it. We're going to be knocking it out. So, anything else that's popped up, Chris, that you think we need to hit?
Nope.
I don't see a damn thing. You guys have been wonderful. Thank you so much for jumping in the chat today. We appreciate all of you immensely. We can't say it enough. Go on and share the show. Hit the like button, whatever platform you are on. Make sure that you like it. Give it a heart. Give it a whatever the hell. And make sure you are subscribed. Share the show out. Tell your friends about it. We appreciate that for sure. Subscribe to the podcast. If you miss a live show, they're going right up there. You can listen to it on your own free will, whatever time you want to, in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, whatever. Go and check that out. Of course, the podcast, Apple Podcasts, leave a nice 5-star review. You guys have been fantastic. Go over to sportsbookreview.com. Go over to sbrpicks.com. You can watch our introduction video. We're going to tell you how we plan on covering the college football season in that intro video. So do us a favor and go like that as well and subscribe to their YouTube channel, sbrpicks.com, sportsbookreview.com. You can find all of that over there. WinningCuresEverything.com is our website. Everything you need to know about us is over there. And with that said, Chris, if there's nothing else, we are getting out of here. Take care of yourself. Take care of each other. We'll see you again tomorrow.
Thanks for checking out Winning Cures Everything.